guys, it's Dagan from PMTV UK, and with it being the 50th anniversary of the Electro Harmonix Big Muff, I thought I'd do a little shootout between the three bass Big Muffs, the Normal, the Nano, and the Deluxe. The Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff are little green boxes of absolute wonder. If you've heard a big, fuzzy, loud bass sound on record, there's a 90% chance it'll be an Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff, either one of these or what they're designed after, the original Sovtek Green Big Muffs, which were designed for guitar, but they were slightly warmer, slightly thicker lows, so bass players love them. Those ones go for hundreds of pounds back in the day, but these guys are nicely under 100 British pounds. Like I said, these little guys are based off the old Russian green Big Muffs from the mid-90s, like a cult classic that have the old Sovtek capacitors in, I believe, which they don't make anymore, or they're illegal to own, or something, but this replicates that perfectly. The original ones were for guitar, like I said, but I use one of these with guitar, and it sounds absolutely mint. Nice and creamy, a lot more low end. And there's different variants too. There's this, the standard bass Big Muff. There's the Nano Bass Big Muff, and the Bass Big Muff Deluxe, which is a big guy, but we'll get to that soon. Hence why I'm doing this lovely three bass Big Muff shootout video. Nothing quite sounds as sweet as a bass through a Big Muff. They're remarkable things. There's many other fuzz pedals out there which kind of replicate this same thing for a lot more money or a different kind of sound, but a bass Big Muff is where it's at. And I'm going to talk you through them right now. What's your favorite though off the bat? Do you use one? Do you use this one, the Nano one, or the Deluxe? Have you got an original Russian Big Muff and you like to use that instead of this? Have you compared them yourself? Because I've compared them and I think they sound pretty darn similar. Are you a Soviet? Have you got a collection of illegal capacitors somewhere in a drawer that you're trying to sell on the black market? Because I might buy them because I like these that much. That's a lie. Let's get started with this video. This guy is the original Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff. Do you know when a pedal just makes you play better? When you've got so much fuzz and overtones happening, it just makes you play better. And I believe that Muffs do that. Like, that fuzz sound with the bass is just so phenomenal. It's great. Like I've said, this is based off the original green Russian Sovtek Muff from the mid-90s, the cult classic, but it's a lot cheaper, it's modern, and it's just as good. It's super simply laid out, one input, two outputs for a dry out as well, so you can run this one sound being affected by your lovely fuzzy bassness, the other one just simple, lovely, clean dry out. When you got one of these, who wants that? It's ridiculous. I don't really know what context you'd use that in, so let me know down below how you would use that. The top is the same as any usual Big Muff. You've got a sustain, which is pretty much gain, tone, and volume. There's a little switch down below, which at the bottom is for dry, so even if you're coming out with the affected output, there's still a dry signal coming alongside. The middle is normal. And the top is a bass boost. These bass Big Muffs, like I said, are based off the old green Russian ones. So they're a lot creamier. They're a lot more friendly to the low frequencies. That's why bass players used to use the green ones back in the 90s. It just kind of boosts it some more because who doesn't love low end? Who doesn't love a good low end? Kim Kardashian, for example, great low end. Not as good as this though. I'd much rather rarry this guy. Electro Harmonix also supply you with a battery. Which is what we're turning on right now. It's great. And if I remember correctly, the batteries have a little guy on flexing his muscles. He looks like someone, but I'm not gonna say who. So that's enough of my utter rambling. Let's hear this guy. Everything's kind of, well, the tone and the sustain are about three quarters of the way up, and the volume is just over half. This is the dry sound. We're going into a Fender Mustang GT, by the way, for people who are asking. That was with the bass boost on. Let's put it to normal. So it's less fluffy, it's a bit gnarlier, but like with everything bass muff, it's not unpleasant. Some fuzzes can be quite unpleasant and very midi and in your face. This guy is just nice and fluffy. Let me show you the dry sound as well. So just to reiterate, this is clean. This is normal. And this is them both together. horrible feeling that that's not going to come across very well on YouTube, because you YouTube folk have got a horrible habit of compressing the videos when you put them up. So I suggest coming into a PMT store and trying one out for yourself. Let's go back to normal, because why not? Put everything halfway up and I'll fiddle with some controls. So this is everything halfway up. Halfway up besides the volume, because it was just too quiet. Let's play that instead. Amazing pedal. Such beautiful, beautiful sounds no matter what you do with it. Sometimes it's a bit quiet, but nobody plays these quiet. Nobody ever plays these quiet. Whether you're using a bass or guitar, the great things. So, whether you're watching this as a series or by itself, I'm gonna do a little shootout between this guy, the Nano Bass Big Muff, and the Bass Big Muff Deluxe. Let's nuzzle on over to the Nano Bass Big Muff. I wish you guys were here to experience a loud, loud Big Muff. You've got to come into a store and try one of these guys out for yourself, because I hope it's, well, your pants aren't shaking like mine are. This is the Nano Bass Big Muff, a lovely little box of joy from the people at Electro Harmonix celebrating their 50th anniversary this year of 2018. 2018? Definitely 2018. It's a great little thing, kind of set out the same as its bigger brother, the normal Bass Big Muff with sustain, which is pretty much a gain, a tone control and an overall volume control, but in a much smaller compartment, which fits on any normal size pedal board these days. Electro Harmonix are kind of known for their big DAF pedals, as people still buy. I mean, I've got one of these guys' bigger brother. I've got a normal big muff itself. You just buy them for the novelty. It's, and in your head, they sound a bit better. But this and the bigger one do sound the same, but the sacrifice for the smaller enclosure, you do lose a couple of features, like you lose the dry output and the bass boost switch on the front. So the only switching you get with the little guy there is normal bassy muffy goodness and a dry signal going alongside your lovely bassy muffy goodness. So again, being a Bass Big Muff, it is based off the old classic 90s Russian Sovtek Big Muff, which goes for hundreds of pounds these days, that were a cult classic in the 90s used by guitarists and bass players alike. But the green Sovtek ones, what this is essentially a replica of, are a bit more warmer, of a bit more low-end, which is why bass players were drawn to them, and myself, because they're great. So I'm going to do some playing for you now, because I've rambled on long enough. Everything here is at 1 o'clock. I'm going to play something, have a little mess with the dials, and let me know what you think down below. I'm also going to play a riff, which I'm not sure what it is, so let me know. I'm going to take advantage of being on YouTube here. I've got a song in my head, a riff I'm playing, song in my head, riff in my fingers, and I don't know the name of it, so let me know. So this is the dry sound. With some muff! everything back to the way it was. This is it dry. Through a lovely Fender Mustang GT. And this is it with the dry switch on, so the clean sound is going adjacent to your lovely Muffy bass sound. You know, I am doing a little, whether you're watching this individually or as a series, shootout of the three Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff pedals. If you're not subscribed, subscribe so you can watch that. And on paper, these guys are the same, just in a bit of a smaller enclosure because this one, well, the green Bass Big Muffs take a lot less components or smaller components than the normal Big Muff, so you can fit it in a smaller enclosure and not really sacrifice that much tonal difference between the big one and this one. On paper, it's the same. But playing them back to back, on the dry setting on the little switch on the front, the clean signal's coming through a lot more than on this guy, which I wasn't expecting, but that's why you do these, watch these shootouts on YouTube, and it's why I do them for you. Interesting. So that was the little brother to the usual Bass Big Muff. Slightly smaller enclosure, but you do sacrifice that bass boost option on the little switch and the direct output. It runs on a 9-volt battery or a 9-volt power supply, and I hope, again, it comes with that lovely 9-volt Electro Harmonix battery where there's a dude flexing. If it doesn't, let me know down in the comments and slate me! This is the big dog. This is the Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff Deluxe. This is the perfect beast you need to get if you want to totally sculpt your luscious bass sound. They've kind of taken the very popular Bass Big Muff, which is based off the old Sovtek Green Muffs from the 90s. Lovely things, but very expensive now. And pumped it full of steroids and cool features and lots of lovely goodness that I'll talk about now. It can look quite intimidating. Like, what do these knobs do? I don't know at all. We'll start with this guy on the left, nice and simple. This is the volume control, exactly the same as the normal Big Muff and the Nano Big Muff. But this is where it gets interesting. This is a blend control, so you can blend in your dry bass sound with the fuzzy goodness. On the Nano and the normal Bass Big Muff, you just have a little switch. Whether you want to add the dry in this one, there's a lovely bend. To the right of that is a tone control, and to the right of that is a sustain, which is pretty much just a gain control. So the right of that though is where it gets really, really interesting. They've featured a noise gate on this bad lad, which is very, very handy because sometimes bass sounds can get a little bit out of hand, and who doesn't love a good gated fuzz? Cracking and saves you having to buy another pedal. To the right of that as well, finally, is a crossover section, which can be activated with this switch right here. It adds a high and a low pass filter to your lovely bass sound, which you can use with or without the fuzz. So it's like having an extra cool little pedal. We'll play with that shortly though, if you don't know what that means. It also features more ins and outs than one of your dad's blue movies. There's one input here, one affected output, there's a dry output, and a buffered XLR DI output here on the top left. So you can run this straight into the mixing desk and blow everybody's tiny little minds. This guy certainly would look out of place on your pedal board, whether you be a guitar player or a bass guy. And also, it'd be a great little tool for in the studio to add little cool nuances here and there. Who doesn't love a good fuzz? Like I've said in the rest of them as well, these can be used with guitar or bass. They are based off the old Russian Green Muff, again, because those guys had a lot more low end, more of a smoother, creamier sound, which is why bass players used them back in the day. And it's why I've got this guy right here next to me. But let's hear some sounds from the Deluxe Bass Big Muff. So this is a dry. And this is without the crossover, just the muff. We can be louder than that, can't we, guys? Can't we, kids?
Yeah.
got a lot more attack than the standard Bass Big Muffs, to my ears anyways. The best way to get it is to come into a store and try on for yourself, because YouTube does compress a lot of stuff. But let's bring some of the blend back so you can hear more of the dry sound. Maybe not that much though, because it's a bloody muff video. You hear more, that's halfway. I'll be wearing this on our headphones though, because no one should pick scrape on a bass. My pick's ruined. Let's take some of that, the blend back to get some of the dry signal through, because it is a very, very nice sound. Let's keep them as they are, because it's a great sound. And you watch my other Deluxe bass, watch my other Bass Big Muff videos if you want to see what these guys do. Let's go over to the crossover though. The noise gate is pretty self-explanatory. You can kind of hear it. So there's no unwanted noise there at all. Let's turn it down. Like that. Hopefully that comes across okay. But let's show you what the crossover function does now, which is foot switchable with this guy. As you see, there's two knobs, one for a variable high pass filter and one for a variable low pass filter. The low pass filter kind of rounds off the low end and leaves a lot of space for those high flying fuzzy frequencies. It's awesome. And the high pass frequency filter knob of destiny kind of just makes it less muddy. And not that this is really a muddy pedal anyways, but you can really make it really precise. You can always play gent on this with the intensity of the fuzz and the intensity of the gate. I'm not going to do that though. I'm not a gent player, but we'll have some fun sounds. Have a listen. That's a bit crazy there, guys. Sorry about that. I forgot to mention as well, it has got a little input pad here if you're using an active bass like I am. It takes 10 dBs right out of it. So as you can hear there, this thing has every conceivable fuzzy, distorty sound you can ever imagine. With the cue controls of a high and a low pass filter and a built-in noise gate, it is literally the ultimate fuzz pedal if you want that creamy sound for guitar or that creamy sound for bass. That's why it's so popular with bass players, that lovely, lovely, nice little bit of low end. So that was the Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff Deluxe. A cracking thing, and happy anniversary again, Electro Harmonix, of 50 years of the Big Muff. I bloody love them. Everyone bloody loves them. But this guy is a very special piece of kit, ideal for the studio or stage. But I reckon if you're anything like me, you've got an extremely short attention span, so try to rattle through this guy as quick as possible. I can't stress enough, you've got to come into a store and try one of these for yourself. Or let me know what you think down below in the comments. Is this your favorite? Is the standard Big Muff, bass Big Muff your favorite? Do you like the Nano one, even though it's got a little few less options? It fits nice and snug on your pedal board. Or do you use an ordinary Big Muff for bass? I don't know. There's lots of crazy options you can do, because like I said, I use one of these normal ones for guitar to get a crazy, funky, fuzzy sound, because I'm not as fast as the other guitar player in my band, so I've got to do something to turn people's heads. But yeah, happy anniversary again, Electro Harmonix, on some cracking Big Muff pedals. That was the Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff Deluxe. So there we have it, guys, a little shootout of three of the best pedals on the planet, the Electro Harmonix Bass Big Muff pedals. This guy, the Deluxe, the standard one, and the Nano one. If you'd like to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. If you want any more info on these guys, check out pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. Each one of those lovely stores has its own Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook page. We should like your local one or them all if you feel that nice. Go into every different store and try a different bass muff with a different bass. Guarantee you'll have a whale of a time. I've been Dagan, and I shall see you next time.